I brought this resolution today because I think most of us agree that we're at a divided time in our history. And I think it's appropriate that we look back in history and realize that we've been there before and in worse ways. So today, Mr. President, I'd urge our members to reflect on the Reconstruction period, maybe do a little reading. And to the people who are watching us today, I would urge the same. The Reconstruction period is a tumultuous time in our history. And I think it's tempting to look at history as either good or evil, and to pick out villains and heroes. But I don't think that's where the value lies when reflecting on this period. I think the value lies in learning the lessons of progress made and perhaps opportunities missed, which are really two sides of the same coin. And learn from that and how to advance opportunities and do better based on what we can learn from history. We're not always doomed to repeat it. Sometimes we can make better choices based on our understanding. Mr. President, during that time period, that decade that marks the Reconstruction period, the 13th, 14th, and 15th Amendments were passed. And I think those are probably the most impactful and important amendments outside of the Bill of Rights. So that was a proud moment in our history. Incredible progress was made. But an important lesson is after that decade, the country descended into partisan bickering, and the momentum of those good deeds and moral motions were lost, not picked up again until the 1960s, sometimes called the Second Reconstruction, and largely due to the leadership and inspiration of Dr. Martin Luther King. So I think that we're in a similar place, but less divisive, and I think we shouldn't miss the opportunity to reflect on our history, realize that we can work together and make this nation a better place for all of our citizens. So I commend this resolution to you.